We have all burned. Down in the fire pits, or from the brander's iron in the solitarium. We have all touched fire. It leaves scars, even for us. We carry them proudly, with honor. But the scars we took that day on that battlefield, we bear only with shame and regret. They are a memorial in flesh. A physical reminder of everything we have lost. A burn, even we fireborn, cannot endure without pain.
Amongst all legions of the Adeptus Astartes, it is not uncommon for the sons of the legion's primarchs to devote themselves entirely to their will. Loyalty is bred within his angels as their single most virtue to fight alongside and at the behest of their gene fathers. Whilst many sacrifice life and limb for their legion, there are legends of those whose sacrifices are made not only for the survival of their chapters or their battle brothers, but in some rare circumstances, for the enduring renewal and glory of their primarchs. Sacrifices such as Artellus Numeon, first captain of the Salamanders' first company. Born on Holy Terra, Artellus Numeon served within the Salamanders' Legion of Adeptus Astartes as commander of the elite Firedrake's company. Commanding his Primarch Vulkan's Pyre Guard, Artellus would fight alongside his Primarch on numerous occasions, including the infamous battle of the Istvaan 5 dropsite massacre. Watching his legion be utterly decimated by the forces of the traitor Primarchs and their legions, Numeon would nonetheless survive the betrayal. Organizing the retreat of the surviving forces of the Salamanders, Iron Hands and Raven Guard aboard the warship Fire Ark, the forces aboard the Ark would conduct hit-and-run raids against the traitor forces for several months. Becoming the de facto chapter master of his legion, Artellus would be revered by his brothers as both the martial and spiritual leader of their fractured forces during the tumultuous months in the wake of their Primarch's supposed death. Numeon's band of warriors would eventually be discovered by the Wordbearer's Legion under the command of Dark Apostle Valdrek Elias on the planet of Trawis. Yet it is on this world that hope would be rekindled within the 18th Legion, with the arrival of Cabal Perpetual, John Grammaticus, informing Artellus that the artifact known as the Fulgrite was located on the planet's surface. Grammaticus would tell the Loyalist forces that the Worldbearers sought the same substance under direct orders from their first chaplain, Erebus, a substance which would be vital in saving the Salamander's Primarch, Vulkan. The Salamanders would combat the forces of the 17th Legion, carving a path to the Fulgrite. The Salamanders would obtain their prize, yet Grammaticus and a sleight of hand would blind Numeon and steal the Fulgrite away. Elias would injure Numeon with a shot from his bolt pistol before being joined via warp portal by Erebus. Finding Grammaticus and the Fulgrite missing, the Dark Apostles would leave Trawis and Artellus Numeon would be left for dead. Artellus Numeon would be taken prisoner aboard the Fire Ark by the Wordbearer's Legion, until the intervention of the Ultramarines Legion forces led by Sergeant Aeonid Thiel. Taken to the Ultramarine homeworld of Macrag, Numeon would be reunited with many of his Salamander brothers and, as a fortuitous twist of fate, the remains of his Primarch. His Primarch seemingly dead after being scorched upon re-entry within Ultramar's atmosphere, Artellus would spiral into a deep depression, refusing the call to assume the mantle of the new master of the 18th Legion. After many days of solitude, Artellus would rekindle his Legion's warrior spirit, embarking upon a heroic voyage to reunite his Legion with their Primarch, Vulkan, on their homeworld of Nocturne. Traveling aboard the battle barge, Charybdis, the expedition of the Salamanders to return to their homeworld would be beset by the forces of the Wordbearer's Legion and foul demons, with their unavoidable venture into the Ruinstorm. Facing insurmountable odds, the Salamanders would be saved by a psychic projection of the Primarch of the 15th Legion, Magnus the Red. Conversing with Numeon, Magnus would test the captain of the Firedrake's resolve, inquiring as to what sacrifices Artellus would be willing to give in order to resurrect his gene father. The Salamander's expedition would break through the Ruinstorm, yet be pursued by a fleet contingent of the 14th Legion, the Death Guard. Attempting to invade and conquer Nocturne, the Death Guard invasion would be stalled by the Salamander's Legion, whilst Numeon and his brothers interred Vulkan's body within Mount Deathfire. For a week, they would conduct their Promethean ritual, but to no avail. The final setback would bring forth the words of Magnus the Red to the forefront of Artellus' mind. Stripping his body of his armor, a mark of command, Artellus would depart from his brothers. Unflinching in his belief that his Primarch would rise again, Numeon would cast himself into the crucible of Mount Deathfire, his sacrifice reawakening his gene father and stoking the flames of rebirth for his legion.
We Salamanders are taught to be masters of our emotions. As such, we are not given to sudden bouts of apoplexy. But you risk the failure of that resolve if you try to convince me of my father's death.
He lies in state, a cold corpse in Rakrag's deepest mausoleum. His sons maintain a vigil over his body.
Exasperated, Feel shook his head.
Artellus.
But Numeon would not hear it. He scowled, disgusted.
The Wordbearer was a more gifted dissembler. He spoke of the Fulgrite, a weapon of immense power, capable of slaying an immortal Primarch. My Primarch. I reject you both. I deny these falsehoods, though I cannot fathom why a loyal son of Gilliman would manufacture such an obvious and heinous lie.
Anger and pity warred in Feel's eyes as he met Numeon's gaze.
You are not yourself, brother captain, so I shall overlook your insults. I speak truthfully, to the very best of my knowledge.
Then it is your knowledge that is flawed, sergeant,
countered Numeon, ending the conversation with a simple declaration.
Vulkan lives.
This has been a tale of the great Imperium of Man, read by the Remembrancer. Artellus' sacrifice was not the first made in service to the Imperium, nor the last. They are countless throughout its ages of struggle and strife. Remember with pride Numeon's martyrdom. Let not his sacrifice be forgotten.